majority of people can control their diabetes or their pre-diabetes with a low carb diet, which is something under 100 grams, probably under 120 grams. So, but it's a little bit of trial and error. It's a matter of finding what's right for you. As I said before, what a lot of people do is they go hard, go early. They go they're pretty strict initially, and then once they've achieved their you know, improved their metabolic health, stabilized their blood glucose, they can back off a little bit and try and insert some forms of healthy carbs and see what effect it has on them. And then they usually find out the right sort of balance. David?
Yeah, I've just about that experimentation. So we're relentlessly fascinated by our successes, but also by our failures, Peter. And when we looked into the people who initially did well and then failed, we found something really, really interesting. And that was that the great majority of them were actually carb addicts who could not moderate. So they did early and hard. They cut out the bread or the potatoes or whatever it was. But then sooner or later, there's a holiday or Christmas or whatever. And then they go bad as ever back to it. And those people, when you talk to them and say, do you think you could be addicted to carbs? They say, definitely. They know. And for them, moderation is impossible. And that was part of my very poor advice at the very beginning, because I always taught moderation for bread. And I can tell you, there are many people who cannot eat one slice of bread. Many people who can't manage a small piece of cake. I was one of those. So I know I couldn't eat one biscuit. I'd have six. And if I was stressed, it would be more. And so we've really begun now to research carb addiction as a very significant problem in the maintenance of people's improvement.